from your group?
Sure. At this table, I'm the only one that actually has used abaqis, so I was the one doing the talking. But like I had said before, I think, you know, the what I love about abaqis, it is it can really be anything to anyone. I mean, for each facility, they can use it really as little or as much as they like. We do have some requirements. We have a kind of a quarterly, the way we've operationalized it, we have a quarterly requirement that they're doing the interviews. We haven't had stage two for very long, so we're still figuring out how to operationalize that piece of it, because it is a little bit more in depth than stage one. Stage one is the interview process, which can be assigned out to, you know, numerous folks in the building to get that information. And that is required to do quarterly. But you can use it as much or as little as you like. And I think some of the facilities, some of the administrators that have really taken to it, they use it on a daily basis. There are pieces of it that they use on a daily basis. With the family interviews, the staff interviews, and the resident interviews, as well as the observations, there's no reason why you can't grab a piece of that every day, you know, when you do your walking around the building, and fill some of that out. Now, you don't always have to put it into the system, but it's not a bad idea to, because when you go to pull reports, you can pick when you want to pull that report. So just being able to, the flexibility of it is what I like most about it. And from a regional standpoint, the other thing I like is I can see it wherever I'm at and drill down to the buildings. I was just showing them here. I can drill down to, I had a, looking at the risk thing you were talking about and the activities was flagging at one of my buildings. And you can drill down, it was the evening activity, and then I can drill down further and see the nine residents who had answered that negatively. So that gives you an opportunity right there to, you know, either address the activity portion of it. If you have a good activities program, you're going to go out and you're going to talk to those nine folks and make sure they know what's going on. Is there need to be some one-on-ones? You can care plan it. That issue is no, you know, when surveyors come through, it's not going to be an issue any longer. They still may answer it negatively to the surveyors, but you're going to be able to show a plan of what you've done to address it. And once they do that, they move on to somebody else and on to something else. So that they just check that off their list. So.
Thank you. Appreciate it. Mike, would you like to share with this group?
Kind of a similar sample size. Not a lot of us at this table have used it. What I love about abaqis is the impression I got at the Quality Summit last year. I actually found myself on a bus with Andy, didn't realize who he was, but this guy that I was talking to just like exuded enthusiasm about this process. And right? You could smell it, you could I thought it was me, but you know, and later that day or the next day when he was standing in front of us, I realized this is the guy kind of behind the curtain. I found when you can find somebody that is so knowledgeable about something and equally passionate about it, they're going to stay on top of their game. And since he's behind the scenes on what's happening at abaqis, he's always thinking of what the next step is. That's the kind of product I want to align myself with. And then these Medline guys are all pretty good too. So it's actually one of the things that we love is that we've ended up partnering with a couple of great groups. We were in Arizona, were thrown into the QIS. We were moved up in the queue. And so for those of you that think this isn't till 2013, and so you've got MDS 3.0 to deal with for the next 12 months, and then you'll deal with IT, health IT, and then you'll get to the abaqis, I would tell you that I would start your journey sooner now. We love that it has allowed us to stop our family satisfaction survey program and use abaqis for our resident family satisfaction surveys, that we can stop our mock survey process and we can use abaqis for our mock surveys, and we can stop all these separate isolated programs and actually do the same thing. The last thing I would say that we love is now all of our department heads know what surveyors do when they go into a resident's room. And they know what the surveyors are looking at in other people's departments. So we've always had this guardian angel program where department heads are assigned to 5 or 10 residents and they go in and say, hey, I'm Mike, I'm your guardian angel. So you know somebody here. And now what we do as part of our guardian angel is those department heads do that interview. And so while the social service person or the dietary person is sitting doing resident interviews, they're also, what, looking around at the room to see the environmental check, right? They're finding out about abuse and the way the questions are asked. It really opens all of their eyes. So when survey has come in our building this year for QIS, it feels like it is an interdepartmental team experiencing the survey and not just the DON and the administrator hiding under their desk, wondering what Department of Health is doing. So.
Thank you, Mike.
Yeah, good question. So if you're like us, do you want to take it?
No.
If you're like us, some of your department heads are really computer savvy and some aren't. And the great thing about it is some of our department heads actually carry their portable little laptops or iPads into the room, and some people print out paper and have a pencil and erase. And you can do either way. What's great is a resident interview, even the first time through, it takes 30 to 45 minutes. You can do it much faster than that. We found the first time through it took a long time because these questions were brand new for many of the residents. Once the department heads realize these are the exact questions that the surveyors are going to be asking, they actually get pretty fired up, I've found, saying, hey, Mike, maybe we can ask every resident in the building all these questions and do it 4 or 5 times, so by the time survey actually comes. And so it actually turned the tables because I thought I was going to be overbearing and ask too much of them, and they're the ones that overcommitted. So does that answer their involvement? So different buildings are doing it differently, and we'll get into those.
Excellent. Thank you, Mike. Thank you.